Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX launched another batch of Starlink satellites with their first launch from Vandenberg in a while.
Zero, lift off.
The booster which launched, B1049, landed successfully on the Of Course I Still Love You drone ship, becoming the second booster to launch and land for a 10th time.
As you can see from that beautiful view of stage one, having landed on our drone ship for the 10th time.
We'll also take a look at the next SpaceX launch coming up in just a matter of hours with Dragon's first all-civilian mission. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the Inspiration 4 mission is scheduled to lift off at 2 minutes past midnight UTC or 8:02 PM EDT. Inspiration 4 posted a tweet of the Falcon 9 and Dragon sitting on the launch pad with a confirmation of the launch time. They said, with the Inspiration 4 launch now just 3 days away, weather conditions are 70% favourable and we've narrowed down our launch window to 5 hours beginning at 8:02 PM EDT on September 15th. SpaceX posted a tweet saying, SpaceX completed a full rehearsal of launch day activities with the Inspiration 4 crew. SpaceX also posted a tweet with some cool shots of the Inspiration 4 crew with their spacesuits on. NASA Spaceflight posted an article on their website related to another payload which SpaceX will launch. It says Spaceflight Inc. has announced to Geo Pathfinder a rideshare mission to geostationary orbit that will use a lunar flyby. The mission will use a Sherpa Escape transfer vehicle launched as a secondary payload with Intuitive Machines' IM-2 mission to the moon. Michael Sheets posted a tweet with a picture of a Falcon Heavy side booster that rolled past the press center at Kennedy Space Center. Over in Boca Chica, the work on the chopstick catching arms is continuing over at the launch site. The orbital launch mount work has been continuing with Booster 4 currently sitting atop. Here's a view of the possible quick disconnect arm extension being constructed. The ground fabrication building is currently being extended. Jeff Faust posted a tweet saying NASA announces the winners of $146 million in Next Step Appendix N awards for Sustainable Human Landing System concepts, Blue Origin, Lockheed, Northrop Dynetics and SpaceX. This bulkhead stack for the Ground Support Equipment Tank GSE-8 was flipped. Work continues with replacing the Starship 20 heat shield tiles, but they look much better than before. They are also continuing to prepare Ship 20 for testing. We can hopefully expect some super heavy Booster 4 testing soon, as Musk mentioned in a tweet last week. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, we can see that there are a few dates for possible testing. Originally, they had a primary closure date of Friday 17th, but that has since been cancelled, with the primary date now Monday 20th. Then there's also a backup date of Tuesday 21st for some possible Booster 4 testing. Here's a view of the Booster 5 upper bulkhead stack that we saw sleeved last episode. The super heavy Booster 5 prototype is continuing to grow in the high bay as they stack sections. Another Booster 5 ring stack was seen sitting outside. This common dome stack for super heavy Booster 6 was spotted out in the yard. Once again, this video I have to thank Nick Ansuini, who has been out in Boca Chica filming the content. Also, Mary has returned to filming Boca Chica content, so thanks to her as well for being out there capturing the action. Then, as always, thanks to the NASA Spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.